You all hope you all are doing good. Today we are going to learn about science. Let's move on to our first lesson, organ system. Let's have a small recap on our last session. In last session, what we studied? We studied about the digestive system, respiratory system, and circulatory system. In digestive system, what and all we saw? Digestive tract and digestive glands. Digestive tract is otherwise called as alimentary canal. Okay, now let's move on to respiratory system. In respiratory system, what and all we studied? Airway, the lungs, and muscles of respiration. Then circulatory system. In circulatory system, what and all we studied? Heart, blood, and blood vessels. I think you all are thorough with this. Let's move on to today's topic, excretory system. Okay, what is excretory system? Excretory system removes the waste products from our body. It also regulates water and electrolyte balance. Okay, in excretory system, what and all we can see? We can see kidney, ureters, and urinary bladder. Okay, what is kidney? Kidney is a bean shaped like structure. It removes the waste products from our blood and eliminates us urine. Okay, we have a pair of kidneys in our body. Okay, see, we having right kidney and left kidney. Right kidney is slightly lower than the left kidney. Okay, the kidney size is 12 centimeter in length and 6 centimeter in width. Okay, each kidney is covered by a fibrous membrane called capsule. Okay, so where we can locate the kidney in our body? We can locate the kidney behind the abdomen on either side of the vertebral column. Okay, so the kidney are made up of millions of excretory units called nephrons, which are the structural and functional units of kidney. Okay children, this all about the kidney. Let's move on to ureters. Two ureters connect the kidney with the urinary bladder. So see the image here. You can see a small tube like structure coming out from the kidney. So this is called ureter. This will lead to the urinary bladder. So this is a bag like structure which collect all the urines. Okay, so this is called urinary bladder. Urine formed from each kidney and reaches the urinary bladders through the ureter. Next is urinary bladder. Urinary bladder is a sac like in shape and acts as a temporary storage organ of urine. Urine entering the urinary bladder from the ureter slowly fill the hollow space inside the bladder. Urine is expelled from the body through the urethra. Okay, do you know? Every minute, kidney reserve approximately 1.250 liter of blood. Now let's move on to nervous system. Okay, nervous system is a integration of nerves and specialized cells called neurons. The human nervous system is divided into two following. One is central nervous system called as CNS. Then next is peripheral nervous system called as PNS. Now central nervous system. Central nervous system consists of the brain, the spinal cord, and the nerve. Okay, brain. We use our brain to think, read, and write. Okay, the brain is covered by three membranes called meninges. Okay, the brain is covered by a bony case called cranium or skull. Okay, here the brain is made up of millions of functional units called neurons. What? Neurons. Here we can differentiate the brain into three major parts. Okay, that is forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain. The brain is divided into three major parts, that is forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain. Forebrain is called cerebrum. What? Cerebrum. Midbrain is called cerebellum. What? Cerebellum. Hindbrain is called oblongata. What? Medulla oblongata. First, we are going to see about the forebrain. Okay. The forebrain consists of cerebrum, thalamus, and hypothalamus. It is the largest part of the brain. It is the center of human memory. It is responsible for the intelligence, imagination, and reasoning. Next is midbrain. It lies behind the cerebrum. It coordinates the movement of muscles of the body. It helps to maintain the balance of the body. Then hindbrain. Hindbrain comprises of pons and medulla oblongata. It also called as the brainstem. It is called a vital node because it controls the breathing, heartbeat, and other involuntary muscles. It connects the brain to the spinal cord. Okay, again we will see for what forebrain is responsible. Forebrain is called as the human memory, and it is responsible for the intelligence, imagination, and reasoning. And midbrain is responsible for to maintain the body balance and movements of the muscles of the body. And medulla oblongata, it controls the breathing, heartbeat, other involuntary muscle, and it connects to the spinal cord. Okay, children, do you know average weight of a human brain is 1.300 kg? Now last, spinal cord. See here, we can see a clear image of brain here. See here, cerebrum, cerebellum, brainstem, and spinal cord. Here pons, medulla oblongata, and here hypothalamus and thalamus is present here. Spinal cord. Spinal cord is a long tube-like structure which extends from the brain. It lies within the backbone of our body. See here, do you know the brain needs a continuous oxygen supply for better functioning. The brain loses the ability to function when it does not get oxygen for more than 4 minutes. Enough sleep and healthy food increase the efficiency of our brain. So children, we have to sleep nicely and we should take rest, then only your brain will work fast. Now let's move on to peripheral nervous system. Peripheral nervous system consists of nerve extending from the spinal cord to the all parts of the body. It is made up of two parts. One is somatic nervous system, other one is autonomous nervous system. Somatic nervous system carries sensations from the organs to the brain. Okay, what is sensation? If we touch, we feel. That is sense. Okay, so the sensation from the organs to the brain and takes messages to the brain. If you want to lift your right hand or left hand, it gives a message to the brain. So we will lift the right hand or left hand. Autonomous nervous system controls the nerve of the inner organs of the body. Okay, children, I hope you all are understand this lesson very clearly. Now let's move on to hard words, missing letters, book exercise, and question answers. First, we will see the hard words. Parotid. P-A-R-O-T-I-D. Parotid. Sublingual. S-U-B-L-I-N-G-U-A-L. Sublingual. Submandibular. S-U-B-M-A-N-D-I-B-U-L-A-R. Submandibular. Alimentary canal. A-L-I-M-E-N-T-A-R-Y. Alimentary canal. C-A-N-A-L. Canal. Pericardial fluid. P-E-R-I-C-A-R-D-I-A-L. Pericardial fluid. F-L-U-I-D. Fluid. Esophagus. E-S-O-P-H-A-G-U-S. Esophagus. Pharynx. P-H-A-R-Y-N-X. Pharynx. Cerebrum. C-E-R-E-B-R-U-M. Cerebrum. ऑरिकल्स, AURICLES, ऑरिकल्स, वेंट्रिकल्स, VENTRICLES, वेंट्रिकल्स, वेंट्रिकल्स, मेडुला ऑब्लंगेटा, MEDULA, मेडुला ऑब्लंगेटा, OBLONGATA, ऑब्लंगेटा, सेरिबेलम, CEREBELLUM, सेरिबेलम. नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू मिसिंग लेटर्स. मिसिंग लेटर्स, ब्रेन स्टेम, पल्मोनरी, हाइपोथैलेमस, एंजाइम, सर्कुलेटरी, पैनक्रियास. नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू चूज द करेक्ट आंसर. व्हाट इज द लेंथ ऑफ द एलिमेंट्री कैनाल? 3 to 5 meter, 5 to 6 meter, 9 to 11 meter, 6 to 9 meter. What is the answer? 6 to 9 meter. Which organ is involved in respiration? Kidney, lungs, heart, brain. Lungs involved in the respiration. How many kidneys do we have? 2, 3, 1, 4. We have 2 kidneys. Functional unit of brain is dash. Neuron, nephron, brainstem, nerves. Neuron is the functional unit of brain. Blood is pumped by dash, lungs, heart, kidney, bones. Heart, answer is heart. The blood is pumped by heart. Now fill in the blanks. A group of organs together make up an dash system. Organ system, O-R-G-A-N, organ. The process by which the body removes waste is called excretion. E-X-C-R-E-T-I-O-N, excretion. The number of chambers in human heart is dash, 4, F-O-U-R, 4. The functional unit of kidney is dash, nephron, N-E-P-H-R-O-N, nephron. The human nervous system is divided into dash parts, 2 parts, T-W-O, 2 parts. Okay, now let's move on to say true or false. In human respiratory system, length of the trachea is 8 to 10 centimeter. True or false, children? Right, false. The circulatory system is made up of the heart, blood and blood vessel. True or false, children? Right, true. Important functions of the heart is to transport blood with nutrients, oxygen, waste and hormones. True or false, children? Right, true. The brain is protected by the rib cage. True or false, children? Right, false. The functional unit of kidney is neuron. True or false, children? Right, false. Now let's move on to circle the odd one. See here, mouth, buccal cavity, pharynx and lungs. Here, what is the wrong answer? Lungs. Now, nostrils, nasal cavity, pharynx, stomach. Stomach is the odd one. Stomach is the odd one. Mouth, esophagus, stomach, kidney. Kidney is the odd one. Taste, hear, think, smell. Think is the odd one. Cerebrum, cerebellum, medulla oblongata, nephron. Nephron is the odd one. Now match the following. Digestive system, alimentary canal, respiratory system, lungs, circulatory system, heart, excretory system, kidney, nervous system, brain. Now let's move on to answer briefly. Name the salivary glands in our mouth. The salivary glands in our mouth are parotid gland, sublingual gland, submandibular gland. The salivary glands in our mouth are parotid gland, sublingual gland, submandibular gland. What is respiration? The process of supplying oxygen to the tissues of the body and removing carbon dioxide from the tissues is called respiration. The process of supplying oxygen to the tissues of the body and removing carbon dioxide from the tissues is called respiration. What is the function of pericardial fluid? The space between the membranes of heart is filled with the pericardial fluid. This fluid protects the heart from shock. The space between the membranes of heart is filled with the pericardial fluid. This fluid protects the heart from shock. Name the chambers in human heart. Name the chambers in human heart. The human heart is divided into four chambers. The human heart is divided into four chambers. Two upper chambers are called auricles. Two lower chambers are called ventricles. Two upper chambers are called auricles. Two lower chambers are called ventricles. The auricles and ventricles are separated by a muscular wall known as auriculoventricular septum of the heart. The auricles and ventricles are separated by a muscular wall known as auriculoventricular septum of the heart. Arrange the excretory system in correct sequence. Urinary bladder, ureter, kidney, urethra. Answer: kidney, ureter, urinary bladder and urethra. What? Kidney, ureter, urinary bladder and urethra. What are the two parts of peripheral nervous system? The peripheral nervous system consists of nerve extending from the spinal cord to all parts of the body. The two parts are somatic nervous system, autonomous nervous system. Somatic nervous system, autonomous nervous system. Last question. What are the functions of blood? Blood transport nutrients, oxygen, waste and hormone. What? The blood transports nutrients, oxygen, waste and hormones. Blood regulates water level and the body temperature. Blood regulates water level and the body temperature. Blood takes oxygen to tissue and cells of the body from the lungs. Blood takes oxygen to tissues and cells of the body from the lungs. I think you all understand the excretory system, nervous system, book exercise and question answers. Kindly do your homework given in the Google Classroom. We will meet in the next session. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.